This series of instructional videos will help you to understand some of the basics of the collection process that we use. In the lab, we implement a number of methods in order to collect certain information about the brain and its processes. In this instructional video, we will be learning a little bit about electromyography, or EMG. EMG is a signal gathered to represent electrical activity of muscle contraction and relaxation. There are several methods for assessing EMG. Today, we will focus on surface electrode EMG. Surface electrode EMG measures activity of the muscle from the surface of the skin. Although the recording is limited to the surface muscle activity, this technique is favored in lab settings for its simplicity of preparation, operation, and reliable data. Before you begin, make sure you have the necessary tools. A razor, new prep, alcohol, Kimtech wipes, electrodes, tape, leads, and a portable unit. The first step to prepare the participant for EMG is to locate the muscle of interest. In this example, we will use the biceps. Have the participant try to flex at the elbow while resisting a force. This will activate the muscle and help locate the muscle belly. The ground is a reference point whose activity is compared to the activity of the muscle to reduce noise in the signal. Choose a bony area close to the muscle of interest where there is little skin movement to be the location for placement of the ground electrode. Essentially, the ground should provide no electrical output. Next, you must clean the skin on the surface of the desired muscle. This step is important to lower impedances. An impedance is a resistance of electrical signal. Impedance lowers the quality of the signal and therefore lab technicians must take precautions to reduce it. If the area is particularly hairy, a razor can be used to remove the hair. Lightly shave the hair on the skin in the direction that the hair grows. Dispose of the razor in the appropriate biohazard garbage bin. New prep is an abrasive gel used to remove dead skin cells, oils, and other substances that may be found on the skin. Make sure to gently scrub the skin using a Kimtech wipe until the skin is slightly pink. Any longer than this and you could end up hurting the participant. Not much new prep is needed, only a pea-sized drop. Next, wipe the abraded area with alcohol or another Kimtech wipe to remove any new prep leftovers. Let the alcohol dry for a couple of seconds before attaching the electrodes. Once clean, do not touch the area. Excess oils from your hands means that you will need to re-clean the site. If your study requires data collected from an antagonist or opposing muscle, you must repeat these steps for that selected muscle. Don't forget to prep the bony reference. Now you are ready to place the electrodes. Two electrodes will be placed along the belly of the muscle in line with the muscle fibers. This orientation of electrodes will reduce crosstalk or noise between electrodes. Leave a space about 1 to 2 centimeters wide between the centers of the electrodes. The final electrode will be placed on the bony ground area. Next, attach the heads of the leads to the electrodes. The lead head might look like an alligator clamp or a circle snap. Attach them appropriately. Each lead has two heads. It does not matter which head attaches to which electrode. The third and final lead head attaches to the ground. Most commonly, this lead head is green, and the lead is longer than the others. Swinging leads cause noise in the signal, so make sure that the cables are secured appropriately. Take the leads to the skin, with enough slack to allow for unobstructed movement. Attach the other end of the lead into the EMG portable unit. Now you are ready to collect an EMG signal. Remember, practice makes perfect. The more times you use EMG techniques, the more comfortable you will be in preparing them. Thanks for watching!